Yes. Maybe she's going to, yeah, can everybody see me, right? Yeah, I can see it, right? Is everyone through? And I go like this, that means I'm gonna start. Let's just give a chance to someone else. Be sure to write here. If I go here, then they will see me, so. You said yes? What? Yes, yeah, to start, okay. Official, okay. Well, good evening.
Good evening.
How is everybody doing?
Good.
Ready for fun?
Yes.
Oh, sure.
Yes, yes. Okay, we are going to have a lot of fun, but especially what we're gonna have and what we're gonna do is we're gonna learn a lot about what we eat, what does that do to our body, okay? And what to eat and what not to eat. Did every one of you receive one of these?
Smith.
Yes? Did you see over there that said the 7-day diet? Everybody have it, right? Okay, that, what, do you know what that means? I want to say something, but I don't want to go straight to that part. It's not like we're going to lose weight in 7 days, okay? No, it's a 7-day diet. But it's not a 7-day diet, right? It's that you are at the 7-day Adventist church, okay? And I'm not gonna go why it's called 7-day Adventist church. I just wanna say that a 7-day Adventist church is what you see on your first page over there. Open your book and look inside. I would love to read that, but my English is not that good. So is there anyone that can read it real good, loud, that everybody can hear?
Elmer?
Huh?
No, I mean, read.
Yeah, can you do it, please?
I have a big mouth. Okay. We would like to stress that Seventh-day Adventists are not a monolithic group, all of whom think and live exactly alike. In fact, not all Adventists are vegetarians, a circumstance that has made possible many studies on the differences between the health of vegetarians and non-vegetarians. However, it is fair to say that most Seventh-day Adventists have a commitment to a healthful lifestyle, thus their status as the healthiest people in America. It is not the purpose of this class to explore the variations and levels of commitment to this lifestyle among Adventists, but to preset principles of the Adventist lifestyle in general in workable terms so that others may incorporate features of it into their own lives. In America, the land of affluent living, stressful daily schedules, high-fat diets, and the tragic diseases that often result, a group of people who have nagged at the odds. They are the Seventh-day Adventists. Seventh-day Adventists have been the subject of an incredible amount of scientific research. Researchers in the health field take a strong interest in them, in part because Seventh-day Adventists are generally acknowledged to be the healthiest group of people living in America today. A few statistics will illustrate the strength of this claim. One, male Seventh-day Adventists have an 8.9-year longer average life expectancy than does the general population, while female members have a 7.5-year longer average life expectancy. These statistics include all Seventh-day Adventists, even those who follow the health principles only loosely. It is thought that a life expectancy study done on those Adventists who follow the health principles consistently would yield even more dramatic results. Two, though it is not completely certain why this is so, vegetarian Seventh-day Adventists have a reduced risk of osteoporosis when compared to meat eaters in the general population. This probably has something to do with the fact that the excess protein in a high meat diet causes the excretion of calcium in the urine. The SDA diet is a broth rich, is both richer in calcium and lower in protein than the average American diet.
Very good. Now it's clear to you what the 7-day diet is, right? It's just that we want to share with everybody what is that diet. What is that that we eat that keeps us healthy? And like it is written there, not every Seventh-day Adventist follows those principles, but they are principles of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. And that is why we wanted to share with everybody. And as you can see right now, on TV, they're talking a lot about health and about what you eat. And now they're finding out that what is in the meat, that is not good for you. But since the beginning, God says in the Bible, in Genesis 1:29, and you can read it over there, and my friend here is going to read it real loud so everybody can see, what is that God said that we should eat?
And God said, "Behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in which is the fruit of a tree yielding seed. To it shall be for meat. To you it shall be for meat."
So what is going on now is that all those good green seeds, since we just pass it over to the animals. The animals, they will eat it, and then what? Then we kill the animal so we can get the protein that they are getting from the fruit and vegetables and all that stuff. So we get in a second hand. And we should, like God said in the Bible, this is what I made for you. That's it. I'm not going to go anymore because we have a lot to learn today. But I just want you to know that this is the reason why we are teaching and helping. You pay $20 to take this class. When you finish, you let me know if those $20 are worth it or not. Okay? Because $20 don't pay for anything. This will show you interest. You showing interest in the class if you pay something. If I say it's free, nobody will come. But see, if you have to pay for that, you'll be here. And this is the purpose of that. So we're going to start. I want you to know who I am first. My name is Alida. A-L-I-D-A. Alida. Spanish. Hi. I was born in Dominican Republic. And I thought up to not too long ago, I thought that my parents were really, really, really poor because we could not go to a supermarket and buy food. We didn't have a refrigerator in my house. See, we were eating from whatever my mom and my dad were growing on the backyard. And that's what we were eating all the time. Meat, we were vegetarian because not because we wanted to be, because we were forced to be vegetarian. That cost a lot of money. And we were 9 children, my mom and dad, 11. So you can imagine, that was really hard for my dad, raising those children. But we all were Seventh-day Adventists. We all went to school. We all have a degree. Most of my brothers are pastors. And my interest is in nutrition. I didn't go to school for nutrition. I just graduated from business administration. I have nothing to do with nutrition, but I love nutrition, and that's what I really care after I retire and everything. I've been studying a lot, and I have a certificate to be able to teach vegetarian classes, and I love it. And I would love to share with any one of you. If you have any question or anything, if I don't know, I just bring the answer next time. I want to say this too. I have those things over there that you can look at it. They are really, really good. That tells you, in some cases, if you eat a hamburger from so-and-so place, how many calories and how many fat is in there. so you know what we are doing. This is a heart. We can clean our heart, our vein, arteries, or whatever, from all the fat, changing, just changing our lifestyle. See? And this is a vein. This is the blood. Even the blood, if our blood were really red like that, but it's not, because it's running all the time, going up and down, running, running, running. So our blood is like this, full of fat and blood. Okay? And then those little things, when it's, you go to sleep, it's still running and running, but a lot of little pieces stay on the side, the side, the side, the side. And when they don't know where to go, they just accumulate. And this is what you see. And the next day, someone had a heart attack, someone died. What happened? Suddenly dead. What happened? Happened. And they find out that that was his heart.
And
heart.
Cheeseburger and french fries.
And that's what we want to prevent. And the way that we eat, we try to use the less fat that we can use, no animal. And we're going to be learning vegan food, vegan. Because vegan, you can change it to vegetarian very easy. So we're not gonna have eggs, we're not gonna have cheese. And cheese is one of the worst things that you can ever eat. It's like eating fat straight with taste, okay? So if you feel like, oh, I would like to know, is anyone allergic to gluten or anything?
Fish.
Can you write them in one of those pieces of paper?
Yeah.
Okay, because I need to know in case, so I can make something different, so show you that you still can enjoy food in any way, even though you are allergic to certain kind of food. Okay?
Okay.
Any questions before we proceed? Is everything clear? How many have been in one of my classes before? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so we have a real good group that's new. Yeah. Okay, that is good. I would like to welcome, really welcome each one of you. And if you have any concern about the way I speak, because it's, I don't speak English that good, but I speak Spanish. If you speak Spanish, I'd be very happy to talk to you in Spanish. Okay? Anyone Spanish? Oh, I was hoping to hear
someone.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. Well, we're going to start now with the first recipe. It's going to be Latino black beans. We're going to do that one because it's going to be finishing over there while we keep going with another one, okay? I'm going to try to give you between 5 and 6 recipes every night so you have a lot to learn in less time, okay? Okay, so on this one, I guess it should be on. I'm going to turn this one on. Okay, on this one, the ingredients. 4 cups of water. Let me tell you this. The reason why I'm making beans, everybody know beans. Oh, I know, I don't need to learn how to make beans. It's because there's a lot of different things that you can make with the beans. And beans is one of the meat that we eat, okay? One of the meat that we eat. This is my hamburger, okay? So that's why we have to learn how to cook all of them in different ways to make it real delicious. Not just boiled beans with salt. No, we want to make it delicious. So we're going to have 4 cups of water. I already have a water over there. It's getting hot. And I'm really sorry that I don't have that right in front of me so I can be showing you. But one day, we're going to have a whole big place over here with a big, nice kitchen that we can be giving classes to. It didn't look like this, but more presentable. Right. Is that good?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, for cup water, we're just waiting for the water to get, but anyway, it's gonna cook myself. So we're gonna put over there, tell me what we're gonna do.
All right, you're gonna follow in the recipe, one cup diced onion.
Okay, I'm making the recipe double, because we have more people, so I'm gonna put the onions in the water.
In a medium-sized kettle, put the water, onion, celery, bell pepper, fresh garlic, and seasonings. So next to
the celery. Now, I don't want you to go sleep, okay? If you're falling asleep, you can just come over here and watch.
And the red pepper, which would be 1 cup finely chopped red pepper.
Red pepper, not that now.
And the next is the garlic.
Was she right?
1 clove garlic.
Is this supposed to be there now?
No.
Follow the recipe because she's wrong. Okay.
Shame on you.
I was taking some off.
Is this the garlic on there now?
Yes. 1 clove garlic minced.
Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Anybody that's used it, it's the case. It's beef and chicken seasoned, but there's no chicken or beef in it. It's just made, and you almost have to get it, I think, in a health food store. I don't think Publix has it.
Okay, let me tell you this about this. This is a very special kind. It's vegan. Okay. My case, chicken style, chicken and beef. But they says here vegan. They have this. I don't know what is on the other one that is vegetarian, but I don't know what else is in there that cannot be vegan. But this one is vegan. I have the other kind too.
Can you get those out of the store in Deland?
Yes, Deland Bakery.
Yeah.
Yes, you can. And it's like bullion.
If you want,
Can you tell the difference between vegan and vegetarian?
Do you want to know the difference?
I'm trying to think what the difference is.
Yeah,
there's
vegan.
One ingredient in it that makes it not vegan.
No, that is the vegan.
It would be egg.
No, the difference between vegan and vegetarian.
Yeah, the difference between vegan and vegetarian. Vegetarian is that you eat, you don't eat meat, but yes, you eat milk and eggs and cheese, baby product. Okay, vegan, you don't eat those things. No meat. No
eggs,
no cheese,
butter.
No kind, any kind of cheese.
No
the white one, any kind.
And like no oils either?
Oh yeah, you mean oil.
Oil is
coming from cows.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No,
oh yeah, you're right. We don't eat the one that comes from the pork. The oil
or
that they
pork.
Oh no, we don't eat that one. Okay, that's in
it's
gonna
be.
Got
the garlic in there?
Yeah, we have the garlic, so.
One teaspoon of McKay's chicken seasoning.
Which is out in the bowl. It's out here.
It's supposed to be.
We're looking at.
Oh, they're looking at it.
Huh?
There's not
one teaspoon of beef seasoning. We're not there.
Especially this. It does.
One teaspoon.
Okay, one of each, beef and...
It's like bouillon, is what it is.
Yeah,
I'm
right.
I'm
making double, so I'm going to put two.
You might want to trade whoever has the chicken with that, so you can finish your recipe.
And half a teaspoon low sodium salt.
Yeah, trade it, because I need my chicken.
Yes, you do.
But I'm gonna give you a recipe. I'm gonna give you a recipe to make the same something better than this. Chicken seasoning. And we will make you real good, that you can make your own, if you cannot buy. So this is gonna be oiled in here.
See, Lynn, how much was that for the jar of cattle?
How much is it, a jar?
Yeah.
I think it's around $6.
Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna put this aside.
And if you get it from Delane Baker, they have it. Well, that's only for seniors, so 10.
It's gonna be for one, and then you keep going. Because it's just been to boil whatever you want. I'm just gonna let it cook over there, until you see that the onion and everything that I put over there is kind of cooked.
And smell it. Doing something.
Yeah, smell good. Okay, the next thing that we're gonna work on those, because I don't want it to be too late, is the chicken turkey vegetarian meat. Okay, the reason why we're gonna make this meat is, this chicken, is because we're gonna make some kind of sandwich with chicken. Okay, so we're gonna make the chicken. We're not gonna kill it, we're just gonna make it. You can get it?
Okay.
Here, we're going to work, we have two things to work with. One is called the gluten, and the other one is the broth. Is that lady there, back there, are you allergic to gluten? To wheat. Is that part of the
Yes.
So you, that one that we're gonna make now.
I wouldn't die.
She's not.
Okay. We have two things to make here. I'm gonna start with the broth.
Okay. 10 cups of water, which she already has in there.
I'm gonna make it half, okay, because I already have it made. So this is for just for you to know how to do. Okay.
3 tablespoons of the chicken-like seasoning. Is this what you
Okay, this is the chicken-like seasoning that I made you.
It'll be coming up.
I will show you in a little while, but I'm gonna use it now, but I will show you the difference between the one that I pass it out and the one that you're gonna be making at home, okay? And this is all the ingredients. She's gonna let me know each one, which is which.
3 tablespoons of chicken.
Like the chicken.
Right. 1 teaspoon of sea salt.
The sea salt.
1 1/2 teaspoon onion powder.
Onion.
And 1 1/2 teaspoon garlic powder.
Garlic.
And 1/4 cup of nutritional yeast flakes.
Well, this is all I have left, I guess. No, I have some more that I can show you. I'm going to use this right now because this is very important. This is your vitamin B's. Okay. Now I'm going to let that water lay out.
Stir all ingredients in a large saucepan and turn to a boil.
Are you following?
Yes.
What's going on?
Boil the boil.
Yes, I just have the water over there with all those seasonings. I just lower the heat on the which one is this one?
The beans.
The seasons, whatever I put over there, because I had not put any beans in there. Yeah. It's just cooking a little bit more. So
now you're gonna make the gluten part.
Okay, what I have over there is the water with the seasons where I'm going to cook the gluten, the chicken. Okay? That's how I'm gonna make the chicken. And I'm going to show it, I'm going to show it to you because I already have a mail there. So now I'm going to make a mix over here that is going to be the meat. It's going to be the chicken that I'm going to cook. And here's where I'm going to kill the chicken.
Okay. We got 1.5 cup raw cashews. Now that doesn't look like cashews. Where are the cashews?
Yeah. Don't scare me. Cashews, remember to always, always wash it real good. It's raw cashews, so you have to wash it because they coming from who knows where, and they pack it and everything, so when you wash it, you're going to see dirt coming.
And roasted cashews do not work the same. You have to have them raw.
Yeah, they have to be.
They'll be creamier when they're raw. 2 cups of water.
I'm going to make one. The recipe I cut it in half because I already made it for you, but I want you to know how to make them, okay? So I have one cup of water.
1 teaspoon sea salt.
Sea salt.
1 teaspoon onion powder.
Onion powder.
3 cups of gluten.
Garlic
powder, I'm sorry. 1/2 teaspoon garlic powder.
Yeah, but you didn't have onion?
You already did.
Okay. And then 3 cups of gluten flour.
The gluten flour.
And 1/4 cup whole wheat flour.
You should follow instructions. This is a mess. That was just the liquid that you put in there. Okay?
Blended.
Yeah, that's not going to work.
Whole wheat flour in a large bowl.
It's not going to work. But I'm going to make it work anyway. Remember, don't do that. Just follow and read instructions.
I need to look at these recipes.